What's up, everybody? Welcome, welcome, welcome. Today's the 362nd day of Make It Song Rare. Today I'm gonna be winking some secrets for this swordless dungeon. I want to add some different kinds of secrets because right now all you got are the bombable ones. What's up, Arcane T? Hey guys. Hey guys. But before I do that, I want to finish this animation. I'm almost like done with it. What's up, Salad Dongs? Make that animation like flow a little bit better. The light part of it when he's doing his the animation for his like energy, I want it to line up just right with the sound effect. How's everybody doing today? Happy Saturday. Happy Sunday for some people, I guess. Loud? Like it's too loud? Like did it like the settings are wrong or the games just has a loud sound effect? How loud was that? Seem fine? Okay. All right. Okay, so I'm gonna take a look at this this waveform here. So it's hitting these peaks right here. These ones are pretty critical. This one. Is like right about 4.0. This one's like 4.8 or 9. More like 9. 4.0, 4.9. Okay, we'll get these first two going on, going here. The 4.01. Okay, so let's put that 4 seconds in. So this is, that's right there. Right here is the first one. Wait, so this is 2 seconds, 4 seconds. Yeah, I think this is the fourth, the frame right after the 4 second. Let's turn on the background so we can see this stuff. Oh, it's your subwoofer? Oh, yeah, sorry. This is one of the loudest sounds in the whole game for like for an ambience. You know, it's just meant to blow you away after like you've gone through this entire dungeon. It's all these secrets, all this puzzling, and then you get that ability and boom, it's just be like, "What? Whoa." And everything shakes. Yeah, it's pretty power. It might be too powerful. Maybe I need to master it some a little bit and take down the sub a little bit. Is the sub too loud or is the sub all right? It's just that it's really loud. Yeah, I think this one's already timed right. That's lucky. Okay. Well, assuming that, Okay, I'm gonna have to play it again. So, Arcane, if it's too loud, man, turn down your sound a little bit. Because we're gonna have to hear this sound at least once more. Want to listen to it and see if if this 4.0 second one lines up just right, or if it's a little, or if it's a little like where when it goes woo. Okay, I got it, yeah. Okay, let's see if that's too soon or too late. Oh. Huh. Well, all right, well, let me, oh. I can't change it right now because I would have to open up Ableton. Well, you know what? Let's try it. Let's try it. Game show sometimes crashes when I open up Ableton. So the stream might stop here, but if the stream stops, I will just be starting it again, all right, guys? So, anyways, let's try this. Let's see if this works. Come on. Let's roll these dice. See what we get. Come on. You can do it. Oh, can we make sounds today? Yes, I think we're good. Are you guys, can you guys still hear me? Is the sound right for you guys? Oh, I can't mess with this sound after the fact. I need to make a new project and import this awesome sound effect because it is like dialed in. I remember this was really hard to make this sound effect. So I'm going to copy it back from here and use this as a raw. I'm going to do one more mastering sweep on this, but it has to be mastered afterwards because I got really lucky with the settings to make this awesome blare noise. Right, good. We're in the imported folder within Songbringers project. Awesome. And I can save this. Gonna call this meditate. Nah. I guess this has to be meditate too. All right, so I'll get the EQing set up so I can master this. Can you guys still hear me? Am I even on the stream? Did I lose you guys a while ago? Oh, it looks like it's all right. We keep streaming. Anyways, I'll need an EQ8 and a spectrum. All right, cool. Okay, so. When it's, let's see how subby it is. It's pretty subby. I'll take this peak down and I'll add some to these valleys. 88. I'm gonna make a big spike at 70, 78. And another spike at 33. This is like almost, this is like what the lowest you can go on this. So I don't even think I can get it one at 32. No, it just goes off the chart. All right. There. That should take out a little. And then probably overall, oh, it took out a peak or, yeah. I need to do sort of like a little bit of overall, everything below 100 needs to be. Let's do one of these. 120? No, 100, yeah, like everything below 80. Just come down. Let's see. This is hitting a peak of like -7, and I wanted it to hit more like -12, so I guess that should be a whole -5. Right, that was still pretty high. So, anyways, Arcane, I need to get some feedback from you, man. Is this sounding better? Much better. Okay. Let me try one more thing. I wanted that volume didn't come out as loud as I wanted it to. It was actually a lot stronger before. So I'm gonna try and add 3 decibels to this whole thing. Okay, so it's not gonna quite peak. But anyways, I wanted to see now. I'm gonna play it again, and hopefully it still sounds okay for you. Like, and yet it's still a little bit louder. So is this okay? Did it rattle the sub or anything? Well, your glasses did not shatter. My neighbors are asleep, so I guess it's all right. Okay. All right. So which way did you like it? Did you like it better before? Or like did you like it better just like the last time? Or do you like it better this very most current time? I'm hoping this one is all right. Let's see. It's stereo. Yeah. Export that. We'll call this one Meditate 1. Just overriding it. And let's get that added to the repo. Hey, what's up, State Off Games? Welcome to today's stream. How are you? Current ones are better. The first one was too powerful. Okay, great. The current ones are better. Awesome. Yay. All right, we got a little mastering done on today's stream. Yes, high five, Arcade. That was a group effort right there, because I couldn't have done that without you checking your sub. I don't really have a good sub in this room. Gosh, yeah, I need to have a freaking good sub, right? To be able to test all this awesome subby sound. What's up with that? Yep. Okay, now we can go on with getting this animation in the right, just at the right timing. It's like just slightly off because the peaks between these sounds are like 0.9 seconds, not like 1 second. Oh my God, what if I put this entire animation, every frame was 0.9 seconds instead? Duh. I could totally make it the whole animation like work perfectly without having to change it. It's like when you're watching a movie and you cannot hear a thing, so you turn it on and then action happens and you have to get and you get deafened. Yeah. I know that. I know that. So thank you, man. Thank you. That really helped. High five. Just like Toe Jam and Earl. Okay, well, great. We have this open too, so I might even be able to do some more sound development today. Sound creation, making music and stuff. Okay, so to get that top, let's see what happens if, what are the differences between these peaks? Yeah, you can totally tell the sound is way is shaped way differently now. It should still have its nice raw awesomeness right here though. It's got a very like sweet distortion going on. Yes, of course, Toe Jam and Earl, man. That's like one of my that's probably one of my favorite all-time video games. Weirdest game? Yeah, it's very weird, right? Oh yes. Toe Jam and Earl and like the original Zelda are like two of my favorite games ever. And Solstice. I like Solstice for the NES. And Crystalis for the NES too. Those are my favorite video games, I think. Of days of old. How far are you with Songbringer? Pretty far, man. Yeah, things are going, it's pretty far. It's getting into the more mature phase of its game development now. I really, all I have left to do now are there's four more bosses to complete. There's like maybe 12 to 20 more enemies to add. There's like only like three or four more key items to add. And then just a few more little features like achievements and leaderboard and stuff like that. So not too much longer. Songbringer will finally have an official release date. I'll have an understanding for what, you know, how like what is going to be a good day to release the game on, you know. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. I'm really looking forward to it because I'm really enjoying making this game, and I think I'm going to really enjoy putting this game out there. Just, you know, like to let other people play it because it's really starting to become an exciting game to play. In my own humble opinion, and like that's very satisfying to be a game developer and be satisfied with your work is an amazing thing. I think it's the first time this has happened in my life, and I've been making games for 20 years. Not the whole 20 years, but since for 20 years ago. So, anyways, that really counts for something. That makes me feel good, you know? So, yeah, this is point 8 4 8 seconds. I'm gonna try something. I wanna make this rocks meditate animation. The delay be 0.848. And see if that lines up even better now. I totally messed that all up because I was like, what's going wrong? Why isn't it working? Because I set the delay supposed to be 0.848. Pre-orders are lasting. Yes, State of Game. Pre-orders are going great. Actually, Humble's done two really helpful sales, And I got to, I still have to get the game on GOG, but yeah, essentially I'm alpha funding the game right now, and it's, yeah, things are going great. I've always been kind of in yum yum noodles mode. I've been a living, I guess I'm well below the poverty line, if you call, like I make maybe $15,000 a year or something like that. That's what I live off of. Less than $20,000 a year for sure. Do you have any ideas about what achievements I'll implement? Some achievements. But no, I haven't really actually written any of them down. But the ones I had thought up were like, of course, you've beaten one dungeon, you've beaten one swordless dungeon, you found at least a you found a secret area, you got any kind of secret item. Finding the jib stash, finding like the really secret items will be probably be achievements. Secrets like that. Secrets are really going to be a lot of achievements, I guess. And the standard things like you beat the whole game at least once. I think that should be an achievement. You beat the game once in permadeath mode. That would be a sweet achievement. But yeah, I'm totally open to suggestions. Yeah, please. Shout out any kind of suggestions you got on achievements. That'd be awesome. I'd love to hear that. 'Cause achievements are so easy to add. They're so fast, right? I hope so. Yeah, I hope so, Stadoff. I hope that's my goal, right? That's what I consider Songbringer to be a success. Does it make enough money to at least get me to make the next game at a better pace and live a little bit better lifestyle, but not too much. Just basically all I need is to get me to be able to make the next game, or at least get the next game to the Kickstarter phase. But still, I don't know, I'd rather have enough cash just to make a game. I would do a Kickstarter anyways. I would always do a Kickstarter because they're so amazing. And it generates so much awareness for your project, but it would be really nice to have some cash in hand to have the peace of mind that no matter what, I can just make the next video game at whatever pace I want. If I want to take 4 years to make a video game, cool. Like I probably won't, but wait, I say that now, but I've already spent like going on a year and a half on this one. Just die 100 times? That's what you want for an achievement? Oh, just no die 100 times and no start at a game. Absolutely. Yeah, I do not want to do any kind of cheesy achievements. No, none of those. Swordless 5-1 is just not doing it for me right now. Gotta dial in the timing for that one. Okay, let's see this again with the meditate now at the right delay. Are they easy? You have to implement something that triggers them, right? Yeah, oh, that's gonna be a really fast thing. Yeah. Achievements are pretty just triggery. Yeah, that's all you gotta do. You just recognize a certain situation in the game, submit the fact that the achievement happened through the Steam API, you're done. And then, other platforms, there's more work for each platform. iOS, you got to do different kinds of achievements. Same thing for Android, if the game comes to Android. But thankfully, Steam achievements are pretty simple. So it's looking good, but it just needs the whole animation needs to line up so that right during this all this loud stuff, it's got the most biggest energy going on. The most biggest. Yeah, let's get this most biggest going here. Most biggest happens right at there, which is 6.5, about 6.5. Which is what frame? Okay, this is 2, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 4.9. 5.5. 6.0. 6.3. 3. Okay, and then this right here, this lasts a long time. This is all the way up to this peak. 3.3. Where are these identical frames in here? Alright, 3.3. Okay, and in this frame right here, I want to arc this one out a little bit. Right now, when this hits, this is like only a tenth of a second it does this frame right here. It's just trying to hint at something. Right now, when it does this, there's some transparent pixels here that don't get applied to the shadow shader. And I want to make it so it looks like the player's shadow is this, right, just for this one frame. So I'm going to add some fully solid pixels. Here. What color? What color should these be? I guess that. All right, so you can't really see it that well for this frame, but that's kind of the intention. All right, so let's make this 3.2. Throw one more frame back here. And then this one turns that off. You just stay this way. Okay, let's see this. Hope for the right timing. Renda! All right, set off. See you, man. Rock meditate. Whoa. It didn't question me. Like, it didn't ask me to overwrite. What did I do? Oh. Because they're already, we got up into 100 frames again, up above. What's up, Vak? What's up, what's your question, man? Okay, gotta re-render this. And then rebuild the texture. Let's make sure that happens. Yep, looks like it's working. And then here, the meditate animation needs %03D or else it's gonna crash. Okay, let's hope for the best here. Let's see if all these line up now. What did I use for server side in my Hero Bash game? I wrote my own code. We had to write our entire own server. I wrote an entire server in C++ just for Hero Bash. What's up, Rocket Bunny? Again, didn't line up right. Wait a minute, I gotta get to the basics here. Some of it did, the first few little bits did, and then that last bit didn't. Use meditate. I want to make sure everything is all being called at the right time. It's been good, man. How you been, Rocket Bunny? How's everything? What you working on now, man? Nim duration. This is a poorly named variable here. I'm changing this to sit duration, so I'm like, what a nim. Whoops. What a nim? The sit a nim. Okay. And right here, I just want to make sure all these are lined up. So it does call the meditate sound. And the hero's meditate animation. Okay, yeah, they're called exactly at the same moment. So, this peak right here. Oh, of course. I changed the delay, so of course it's going to change the way everything turns out, right? So, before I was at frame 65, right? So, let's see, 60, this is, I think it's 65. Can't tell. Okay, I know how to tell. Let's look at the frames. The frames, man. That's all you gotta do. Pretty good. Last week I was in England and got to meet my grandparents for the first time. What? Wow. I'm working on a really good level editor. Sweet, Rocket Bunny. Oh my gosh, yeah. That's awesome. Sweet, it's already right where I... Oh, there it is, bam! 64. Frame 64 is coming out as that frame, okay. 64 times... Or what do we need to get? If we want it to be 6.5 seconds, and we got 0.848 per frame, that gives us 7.6. So we need to add a whole 1.2, or 12 more frames. 12 more frames until that happens. All right. Got it. Got it. Oh, she's gotten better. Oh, that's good. Oh, what if I just add the whole 1.2 to the beginning? Now it's asking me to overwrite. Good. What a day. I can't believe live is actually running. I can make music today. I can make music on today's stream. In fact, I think I will. I'll play with the sounds for the rest of this dungeon. One of the things I'm going to do today is make it so you can walk through a new kind of secret. There's going to be a new kind of secret today. Yes! New secrets! Keep the gameplay really varied, you know? It sucks when a game gives you a way to find the secrets, but only one way. When there's only one way, it becomes very rote. Your repetition to find those secrets is like, I'm just gonna go and use my drill or whatever around the edges of this room and see if there's anything to do that's secret. But when you have lots of different items that can be used different ways, it becomes very interesting how you can find secrets. There's so many mechanics you can use to open up secrets. I exported the whole thing gray. Okay, and I think it was a little fast. I'm gonna take this down to three. Turn off the gray background. For the love. My level editor might turn into a tiny game engine. Wow. Cool, man. Yeah, what's up, A-Siri? Were you asking me about the GLSL? Or were you asking Rocket Bunny? Frames at the end. There you go. Oh, because I forgot to delete them all. All right, let's do this again. Remove all those. That timing was like almost right. Almost right. I think it could have had one more frame. So this should be 3.1, not 3.0 or 3.2. Okay, let's see that again. Timing is everything when it comes to really important sound effects. You're asking me about it. Oh, I'm afraid of using a OpenGL version if not much hardware can support it. You're asking what GLSL version or what OpenGL version? The GL version I'm using is the 2 series. I'm using Cocos 2DX, which is OpenGL 2.x, not 3, not 4, but still not 1 at least. At least it's 2. And I'm not sure how that applies to GLES on mobile. I forget what version on mobile ES is with Cocos 2DX. But I'm pretty certain of the desktop version using OpenGL 2X. It's written in GM, but it allows it. Oh, you save them in the game? That's cool. Wow, you can make it in runtime. So cool. Yeah, totally. You could probably go up to OpenGL 3 these days, huh? And get good support. Or like a good wide, what do you call that? Wide target. Target audience? Is that the word? Or support both. Whoa. That sounds crazy challenging. You have to put a lot of special, like, if it's this version, do this. If it's that version, do that stuff. Thank you. just needs to last a bit longer. How much longer do we have here? We get it to this point. Let's say he's like fading out for all 1.3. At least 1.3 divided by 0.848. No. Yeah. Wait. No. 1.3 divided by 0.848. 15 frames. Well, the tedious part will be having to write two versions of every shader. Oh. Yeah, two versions of each shader. You kind of have to do that, even with Cocos 2DX. I know at least with Android. If you're going to support Android, there's like a lot of stuff you have to test. You specifically have to change your shaders a little bit to support Android. So 15 frames, it's currently at 0.3 frames, which means all these need to be at least 0.6. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, it's a can of worms. Right? Oh, you're just doing desktop only? Oh, nice. That's great. That's great. Yeah, you just made your whole life a lot easier there. Yes. 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 Oh, man. I kind of almost wish that Songbringer wasn't going to be coming out on mobile, because it's like, it's a whole different thing. But it's coming out on mobile for sure. It's coming out on iOS. But thankfully, I don't have to write my own engine. I'm using Cocos 2DX. I'm just doing that way. I guess it's the cheap and easy way to do things. I really wish I had my own awesome custom engine, though. That would be sick. You know? You could do so many cool things these days. Like support Metal or Vulkan or whatever those things are. See this bit where he's holding it, right? Not there. Yeah, here, 3.2. Let's make this a whole even 4. Maybe 5. All right, we'll try 4 first. 4.2. It's a great number. Just not for any particular reason at all. Man, how can I possibly have had like a bowl of cereal before starting this stream? Like a big old bowl of cereal, so big. And now I'm hungry already. What's with that? You recorded a video for your Minecraft series today? Sweet. Found out that I recorded 2 episodes I didn't. Oh, nice. Now you're doing 3. Right on. It's like finding a 20 in your pocket after last night. You're like, yes. Finally right. That's such a cool sound. I love how that's nice. Whoa. Those are so loud. They're so especially loud when all there is silence and maybe a tiny little ambience going on. Anyways, yes, check this in. Check it in. That was awesome. Timing worked just right there. A moment. It's a penultimate moment right there. Look how many frames there are in this animation now. 157. Wow. Oh, yeah. Free points. Hey, what's up, Space? My name. So many points to lose. No. Okay. Gate commit. Oh, I didn't even notice the They're like, oh, let's see this. One more time, one more time. I want to see it at screen cap rate. Yes. Stay for $3.99999. Please. So I just recorded that and I'm gonna look at each frame and make sure I wanna see this one frame right at the middle of it all. Yes. Oh, check this out. So I guess you gotta kind of see this. Like, let me zoom this. Yeah. So the shadow that's cast only in that one frame right there, you get the shadow of Zero's head. Plan on porting the game to old school iPods? Yes. No, yeah, the whole game's been designed the entire time that it, so that it can go down to like a really tiny resolution. It's the NES resolution here, basically, but widescreen. This is widescreen NES. That was what I wanted to make a game, widescreen NES. All right, it's blurring out because it's just stretched on the preview app I'm using here, but you can see that in this frame, the player has his own shadow. And then in this frame, he has Zero's shadow. That looks awesome. And then it's only for a tenth of a second, and then it goes back to this animation. So. Now that that's refined, it's time to do the secret thing. All right, so let's go to a different area. Whoops. I need to go somewhere where I can get an item in this place. Besides that one, besides the for an item. Give me something good. Come on. Yes! Wait, no, that's not what I wanted to do. Not that kind of secret. Okay, great. Now I know where a secret is, but seriously, I want to go to the secret room in this dungeon. That's okay, so right now you can't get into the secret room. Let's find out where the hell the secret room is. I'm going to go into God mode and just run off the screen until I find it. It might be this one. No, it's not, really. That's surprising. I would have thought it was there. Oh, here it is. Here we go. Here's the secret room. Apparently I've been here before. Found something cool I want to show you. Sweet. Let's go from this room to that room. Yeah. Terminator reads your Xcode project files and makes the directory layout match the project's group layout. Oh, interesting. That's cool. It's called syncs. Nice. That's pretty cool. I can see that being really useful in some, in a lot of situations. All right. So what I want to do is let's say that I haven't been to this area. So it's like I haven't done this secret. What are we at? 422, so I want to be at 322. Take that position away. So 322. Let's get rid of that. Now I'm starting at 422, and this is a secret room, right? This is something where the dungeon generator has generated this swordless dungeon and decided that just to the left of this room there should be a secret room. And in the regular dungeons, what you would do is you would bomb right here on this edge. Let's do that and see what happens. See, just nothing happens. So what I want to happen is that you can do a different kind of secret to get through here. So this isn't too hard, actually. All I want to do is make it so that you can walk right here at the very top of this row of bushes. Just be able to walk through. Okay, and that shouldn't be too hard. I want to do a bush that is smart enough to recognize that it's on a secret exit path, and if so, to make itself half as wide or half as tall. Hey, what's up, Zanker? Oh, you know what? I think I need to turn off Ableton because my CPU is going and it's eating up CPU. I might as well close all these audio apps. That was good. That was good to do some audio on today's stream. Okay, there. We should be using less CPU now. All right, so the first thing. Where it creates a bush tile. Let's do something radical right away, and instead of, I'm just gonna make it so that every single bush in the whole game is always twice as or half as high. Bush tiny. Oh, yeah? In-game map editor. Cool. Rocket Bunny was just talking about that. He's making a level editor in-game, too. What's up, Big Mac Dev? Yes, I'm coding for a minute. I'm coding. All right, so we'll just go if true. Bam. All these are gonna do it at first. E collision collision dot size dot y times equals 0.5. I think that's gonna be enough. Let's see. Wait, you're it's 12 high, and then the yeah, this would be maybe barely. Might need one less. Watched a few videos from the first week or two of Songbreaker, and it's super cool to see the progress. Yeah, right? You remember those videos? I had no idea what I was doing back then. I didn't know how to stream. Those are my very first streams. I had no followers on Twitter, no followers on Twitch, basically. Every day was a totally new experiment. I was like, I wonder if anyone will even be watching this stream. Okay, yeah, these are too tall. I can't get the player through those tiny little gaps. This really should be the height minus the player's height. Why don't I do that? Yeah. Minus one. So E dot collision dot size dot Y equals. Clamp F 0. Don't want it to go below 0. Go below 1, actually. Clamp, let's go clamp F. Size minus the player's size. And then clamp that to be at least one high and no more than block size dot y times 2. Okay. See if we can walk through the hole now. Here's what my level editor looks like. What is the name of the pre-made level chunk? Oh yeah, nice. You just draw like that. Ooh, there we go. We can get in. Thing. Okay, now we just gotta make that so it recognizes that it's gonna be a secret path. Yeah, but that's really cool. Isn't it great to make an in-game map editor? Or in-game level editor? It's nice, right? Super satisfying. It's very visual, it's very direct. There's the same kind of thing goes on with create wall tile. Wall tile checks to see if it's a secret. Here's how it does that. It gets the exit direction of a point. And it's useful too, right? Let me see if I can make this like a static function. Oh, good. We're good. We can. Nice. Nice. All right. I can put this at the top of this method and reuse this for the bush. Have you ever played around with the raspberry? No. Yeah, they're cool. That's awesome. I haven't played around with one. That'd be fun, huh? What have you done with it? His secret door. If it's a secret door, and this is a level. Oh, no, I guess this could be it. Yeah, it's secret door checks for the right kind of door. So, yeah, it should be totally allowed. How high does your FPS reach with VSync off? I don't know. I haven't tried it on Windows. On Windows, it works, right? I can turn off VSync and do that. But on Mac, for some reason, I can't get it to allow the frame rate to go past something. It's because I'm using Cocos 2DX. I'm not sure exactly how it works, but I haven't tried it. I have not tried it on Windows, but I know that Scottish Pizza tried it. And then I also improved the speed of the Windows build too recently, where it used the right kind of timer. So it should allow a lot more frames per second now if you're just going to turn off your VSync and go for it. Oh, you also got to turn off your max FPS on Songbringer settings. But anyways, yeah, you would just change, like, if you wanted to check that yourself, you would just go to your max FPS setting and turn that to, like, I don't know, whatever, 9999 or something like that. And then you would have to go disable your VSync. And that's, yeah, neither of these settings are in the game yet, but I mean, they're not in the menu. They're in the game, they're just not in the menu. You'd have to go hack your save game here, if you call that hacking. What does VSync do? It makes sure that what happens with your screen is that it updates the whole screen at once. Yeah, it syncs your frame rate to your monitor's refresh rate. That's a nice, simple way to say it. Thanks. Thanks, hey Siri. All right, I'm going to also make it so this requirement is that it has to be centered. And I realize it'd be a lot more optimal to switch the order of this and statement, of course. All right, there. So if it's a centered path, secret door. If we're horizontal, which would be x is 0, or x is width minus 1. No, this is all about a secret pathway. I guess we gotta get an exit dir just like this function does. Alright, get exit dir. Okay, so if the direction, what is this, a compass direction? Yeah, a compass. Okay, so the compass direction. Is east or west. Then we do this calculation here where we change the height, collision height. This one, I think we have to take the x, or we have to disable the collision completely because even if I were to make this x like 1.0, the player's not going to be able to get around that, I don't think. But let's check it out. Let's see if that works. Smart bushes. That's what we're making here. Bushes that are smart enough to recognize a secret pathway. What do we got? What do we got? Okay, yeah. So every bush so far on the screen is just normal. But this one, it didn't work. Shmeh. Hold on, did this even work? Let's see if the basic part of this worked. Yay or nay? Swordless secrets. This is today's subject. Creating secret access to secret rooms in the Swordless Dungeon. And a new form of finding secrets. Yes. Oh, it worked. Look at that. Okay, so it was that X wasn't... Oh. You see my math problem here? My logic problem? Plato would be pissed at me. This is supposed to be or. That's better. Do you have any tips for learning writing shaders? In GLSL-ES. GLSL-ES is pretty similar to GLSL, so you're gonna be all right there. It's good to learn GLSL, I think. Any tips for writing shaders? Well, I'll tell you what, it's kind of tricky waters because it's a different kind of programming. It's harder to debug because all you've got in front of you are some visual pixels, so you gotta think different when you write shaders. What I would recommend doing is going to shadertoy.com and getting so inspired and look for code that's really short. So just go to Shader Toy, go find something that you think is interesting, but is extremely short. We're talking like 5 to 10 lines. And then look at how they write it. Look at their GLSL code and get a feel for some things, right? And then what I would do is I would go and try and write your own shader that's only one line, or like not one line, but your main function is only like one line of code. All it does is try and change a pixel, change a pixel's color. That's really all you want to do. There you go. There's learnopengl.com too. What's learnopengl? And another good resource is Shaderific. Shaderific.com. Shaderific is great for looking up GLSL functions. And all the types. You should read through this. Here, let me put this link on here. This is super awesome. What do you guys think about the friends beta thing? Twitch friends. Okay, let's see if that worked. You're welcome, man. Yeah. Just basically my recommendation is to start really simple. Really simple. All you do is change a color. Single color. Single pixel. Something really tiny. Oh, it works. And it's super concealed. Look at this. From here. Oh, but I can get through. Oh, I can get through. Yes. So cool. I can walk all around this room. Trying all these edges. But no dice, man. No dice at all. But over here? Oh, nothing? No? Oh, yeah, there it is. That's crazy. Sometimes he misses it because it's only like one pixel wide. So, see? Why did he miss that? I want the opening to be like, I'm going to try one more pixel because I wanted you to be able to hit those when you get, you always hit those because it would suck to have a sometimes go back and check things twice, you know? You haven't seen Use Twitch Friends yet? Yeah, I don't know why they're implementing it either. It's like it's like some social networks are great for your managing your list of friends, right? And then some social networks are just not really, you know, catered towards that. Twitter is like my favorite way to keep in touch with everybody, you know? It's so simple. You can catch everybody's news quick. You can see images. It's like, it's great because you get to choose who you're following and all that. You don't just get fed like Facebook's algorithm worth of what it thinks you are gonna be interested in that day. Being able to use other people, do you mean abuse or what? Yeah, do you see that? Now that this is two pixels, I'm catching this gap every single time. Right, that's awesome. We have secret pathways. Yeah, and I mean, you could see it if I turned on the debug mode. But as a player, the only way to do it is to feel it out. Like, you just have to know it's there or try it. All right. And what does this gain me? Why is this even a cool thing? You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and put this secret item for this room. Just totally obvious. It's gonna put out in the open. What is a secret item for this room? Oh, without having to subscribe. Oh. I see. Area has item. What I'm looking for. Area has item. Does anybody see it? Has item. What? Why am I missing it? Oh, it's not there. There should be an item in this room. It's a secret room. Crying out loud. Shoot. Does it have any items? That would really suck to get into a secret room like this and not even have an item. Let's see. Ah, there it is. Damn. Missed it. Okay. Yeah, there's no item. Well, that's a problem. That is definitely a problem. Let's fix this. I think this is good to check in, though. It's a great little fix right here so far. Oh, I didn't check the north yet. I can't check this in until I check the north. Okay. We have to postpone the check-in. Yeah, I'll check north right now. I was like, should I check north right now? But yeah, I should, huh? Just do an atomic commit, get everything in one check-in. So I'm checking north paths now. And then I'll make sure I'll go back to this world here. Let's go to a different world. Hope that we get a north path for the secret room. Let's see what we got. Dungeon 2. Secret room? Yeah. Oh no, there's only a east path into the secret room. Okay. Next world seed, Xanadu B. Looking for a secret room to the north. Secret room to the north. Come on, come on. Look at the draw. Look at the draw. Lucky number seven. Wait, I shouldn't say that. I want to try number two. Oh, once again, east. Damn. Should I go for lucky letter seven? What's lucky letter seven? A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Xanadag. Yes. Oh, nice. All right, cool. So it's only one to the right. Doing it. Yeah, right. Hey Siri, 200, you doubled your points. It looks like it gave me the whole pathway. Oh, but there's gonna be one pixel in the middle, huh? Yeah, no, I need the whole pathway. Or at least for the collision to be shifted over. No, that's just too confusing. Okay, let's do this the right way. Create bush tile. It's not even gonna create a bush tile. It's collision. It's gonna just delete its collision. Yes, so it's gonna remove its collision. Or just set its collision to be nothing. Yeah, go to category nothing. Boogie, what's up? What's up? What's up? What's up, Boogie? Gotta go. Tomorrow I'm hopefully reading my first shader. All right, Buggy, Bunny, I want to hear, man. I want to hear how it goes. Let me know if you got your shader written or not. That's gonna be your homework. You got to report to Wizard Food. Let him know how it went with your first shader. All right. We got a deal, huh? Deal. Yeah. Okay. So now I changed the category completely for that secret path. Let's see if that works. If I'm like running along this edge, I'm hoping for a secret. Oh, is it gonna happen? It is! Oh, I can walk through north. What the? What? I'm in this secret room where there's nothing in it. What? Even worse. Oh. Anyways, that works good. It's not like I catch an edge either. It just goes every time. Yeah. Okay. We're good. Cool. Now we can check this in. We got north and south. Or now north, south, east, west. All those work. All right, I only change one file. Okay, so we got that is secret door method. This is the method that the bush knows is a smart bush. The bush is smart enough to turn its to like change its collision if it's a secret pathway. Is gonna be awesome because now the game has two kinds of secret pathways. There's the bombs and there's just walking. So now there's a lot more variety in how secrets can be placed in the game. And from now on, I can really get creative with that, like which way I'm going to do it. And then eventually there'll be more. There'll be more gate pathways and stuff. What's up, Pedro? Welcome to the stream, you guys. Today's stream is now fulfilled. I've done the what I intended to do. Oh, it's secret pathway, but now the secret room is kind of weak sauce because it doesn't have an item, so we got to fix that. This is a bush secret pathways. So Pedro, how'd it go, man? You got any feedback on your Your thesis yet, or you gotta wait? You probably have to wait like a week, huh, for them to check it out, get some feedback. But how long do you got till you're all said and done with your thesis? So in the meantime, I want to go to the dungeon generator and work on what's up with this dungeon. Why doesn't it put the item in the right place? Yes, you want the secret troll item, you do, don't you? You've been waiting for the secret troll item. Oh, probably on Monday, all right. No, Boogie, I do want to do that. I do want to do some kind of troll item. Should I just do it today? How long would it take to make a troll item? I don't know. Let's see what happens here. Let's get the item on the screen first. And then if there's time, we could do a troll item. Oh yeah, Friday the 13th, that's right. Oh yeah, the presentation. You guys call it a jury? What do we call it? I think we call it a, do we call it a, we don't call it a jury, do we? Who do you present your thesis to in the United States of America? Your peers? No. Your review board? So I think it might be called a review board. Okay, place item. That's where we're gonna go. Place item function places all the items. Might as well start there. Here's his goal, his boss, his gate. What are we doing? Looping through each item. Oh, right. His goal, boss, gate. These are all special. The last one here, remaining items spread out in order of difficulty. And preferring secret rooms. Huh, I wonder why it's not putting the item. I guess we'll go with verbosity at least 2 to be able to see where it's placing items. A broken floppy disk, when you pick it up, it deletes your game. Oh my god, that'd be so brutal. Yeah, so in Portuguese, it's is what's the word in Portuguese? Is it jury? Is it more like jury, or is it more like review board? Or a gamepad that wrecks your controls? A game, you know what? There's already the panic mechanic, which does that. All your controls are wrecked. Or a magnet that pulls enemies towards you. Yeah, that's kind of cool. These are fun troll items. The deleting your whole game is really brutal, though. That'd be tough to pull off. Dungeon Verbosity 2. We want to take a good look at Dungeon 2's how it's deciding where it puts each item. Text made open so I can actually see all this output. Okay, decisions about dungeon 2, generating dungeon 2. What? Couldn't place dungeon 2. Generating dungeon 2. Here we go. Okay, the items. The last item is a sword. The boss item is a life container. Otherwise, we have bomb container, compass, map. Here's the gate item is lighter. So we got three possible items we can place. Or a potion that makes all the enemies three times as big. A bouquet of flowers that permanently changes the game into a jib dating simulator. Who does he want to date? What's his type of robot? What's he into? Is he into robots? Is he into human girls? Or what? What's his thing? Is he into tentacle porn? Is that what his thing is? We call it jury, which directly translates to jury, but it's the same as the review board. Oh, okay. He's into household appliances. Like the toaster. He really gets down with the toaster, huh? He's like, yeah. Put on some Barry Manilow. Turn down the lights. Get some candles on. Placing item lighter. Placing item map two. Okay, we want to see Dungeon Verbosity 3. Because it didn't say anything about these items. Oh, it's not logging the possible rooms, of course. Okay, so when we choose a room, choose next room parent, it definitely logs out or logs out the. Does it? Oh, maybe it doesn't. It's a toss-up between the toaster and the blender. The blender. Cell dogs bows. I'm looking for a bit of debugging code where it lists out a bunch of rooms. I don't want to write code twice. Here it is. Possible doors. Man, let's copy that. Place item. All right, so we're gonna list out all the rooms. So we're gonna loop over every possible room and look at its room sort. First, no, vector room sort. Okay, so that's pause. Oh, dot R, R. That's it. What else does a room sort have? Struct room sort, dungeon room and wait. Oh yeah. Okay, we want to see wait times 100 and the dungeon rooms X. Or is it pause.x? Yeah, pause.x. And x100 i.wait. All right, there. Now we'll have some more details on all the rooms that it could possibly choose. For the secret room, or for where to place the item, should prefer the secret room. Okay, looking for dungeon two. Generating dungeon two, placing bomb container. We want to look for bomb. I think bomb containers. Is that the last one or is it map two? I don't know. Oh, yeah, it starts at the beginning. Placing item lighter. Placing item map two. Here we go. Sorted. Oh, it already had possible rooms. I just wrote all this and it already had it. Oh, because it gets get possible rooms already reports that. Log three. Derp. I'm wasting time. Writing code don't need. So what happens when you're not you haven't used a bit of code in a minute? Forget how all the mechanics work. Anyways, we got sort possible rooms. 2-1 is the lowest priority. 3-1 3-2, 2-3. 2.0, clearly the winner at 145% or 145 points or whatever towards its weight, which is 2-0 is 1-2-0 here. That's the highest priority room. Not the secret room. Did we place the secret room yet? Of course we placed the secret room already. I just want to see it say secret. Where is it? I don't think it says. But it should. Oh, see, it does. What's up with this? Why didn't I not see that? Oh, here it is. Secret. I just missed it. All right, yeah. So it did place a secret room. For sure, we have a room that's secret. Before it goes and places the puzzle, before it places the items. Secret, for some reason, is not coming back as a high enough priority, even though it's supposed to be double. All right, let's try a secret probability. Immediately has 4.0. Okay, look at this. It did not even change. Oh, you know what? It must be ignoring the room for some reason. It's probably not even getting here. If r.flags... Oh! I'm such an idiot. I didn't notice this whole time that it wasn't even running that code. There, we want to prefer secret rooms even above the fact that it has a flag. Anyways, now we should have the item placed in the secret room. Highest priority place to place an item is in the secret room. Which means that the bomb container is probably going to be in it every time. So I got to fix that. That can't just be how it works. Rookie mistake, I know. Totally. Right, here we go. Puzzle 3, item lighter, item map 2. Boom, the 3-3 is immediately a big old number, higher than all the other numbers. Oh no, it kept overwriting it though. What did I do wrong there? Oh yeah, if r.item is none, okay, that trumps everything else. Okay, good to have this logic finally right. Hopefully right. You know what? Difficulty should be a part of this too. Let's try that. 1.5 plus difficulty. Steve Tramby, Aborson Vell, Azenris. Space my name. Feel to me. To be. Feel so accomplished. Map two, here we go. We got the choice. All right, Chris, this time good. This time the number is a little bit different because it's factoring in a little bit of difficulty now, but it's still the highest room. It immediately puts map two inside the secret room. I guess, oh, one thing I could do is randomize the order of these three items, the middle items. Boogie! It's okay, man. You get your points back. Your hair will grow. It's all right. Okay, but I think of the bug is now fixed. The fact that we have an item now in this room, it should be. Wait. The last thing I want to do is make it so if it is a secret item, or I mean in a secret area, it's just there. It's immediately available. You don't have to find it after you've already found the secret area. You keep getting home and taking a nap through the stream? Nice. Nice. My girl, she'll go to bed every time. Like, I know how to make her fall asleep so easy. If I talk in this monotone voice, she falls asleep so fast. So fast. And by that, I mean my lady, not my girl. You know, I don't have any children yet, but I'd like to. Here. All right, hidden. I think the whole point of this is that it shouldn't be hidden. I'm just gonna go to this room and set a breakpoint there. My female lady person human friend. Yes, that. This made me think of salad dongs. Oh man, I gotta appreciate this one. Your animate carbon-based life form acquaintance with whom you are engaged in a mutual instinctual pair bonding arrangement. Exactly. I shall appreciate this later when I can give it my full attention. Breakpoint! Consensual. Oops. What was that I just did? Do hide item in foe. Forty-nine times. Yeah, it's very catchy, man. Oh, it's already caught me. This time it should get past this. But hopefully it gets past everything else. Hidden. What did that turn out to be? Hidden and swordless. Hidden true. Oh. So hidden, let's do this. If it's and not is swordless and flags and K flag secret. Okay. So do not hide it if it's a swordless secret. Let's see what happens to the code now. Should just throw it on the ground. Put it on the ground, freaking anywhere. Anywhere. Hidden false. Contain should be false. Good. First item. Doesn't look like it's gonna have a special place for it or anything. But it probably needs to be moved downward. Okay, I think it's getting in there and creating it. Yeah. All right, let's see where it puts it on the ground. It might need to go downward a little bit. Yeah, see, you just threw it in the middle of the, of nowhere. How am I supposed to know what that is? Where is this? What is this? I guess that might be cool. I mean, this is a secret room, in fact. You know, you just found this secret room, and you gotta be paying it enough attention to find it. Or we could add a little velocity. If we add a tiny bit of velocity, it will automatically jump onto the. To ground or whatever. Let's see what happens to that. There must be an actual bit of land right back there. Wait, what if this is, needs to be like one or something? Or negative one. Let's go negative one there. I don't know. It's not working. Let's make the position smarter. Move system. Get any valid position for dogs. 5 points. So it's so solid. Just want to make sure the guy has points to give out. Yep. Yep. No, it's not artificial. I actually earned those points. I've been here the longest, man. See, I think there's a piece of land back there. Why else would it keep putting the item right there? It's like really happy with that little location in the middle of the water. What's up with that? Fiat, they're fiat currency. It's gonna cost 4,100 points. Okay, you just like silently move the item upward. I can live with this, I guess. Still it's moving it. Yeah, it should be at least one position to the south. Why does it delay and then jump? Creating items. Every item should always have the run while paused flag. Damn it, that's an AI flag. I don't want to give an item an AI just to make it run while it's paused. What do I do? Should be more of like an activate or collision, maybe. Okay, I'll start by moving the position downward so that it's not right on something that's in the middle of the screen. Accident is easily. So funny seeing it jump like that. I don't know if I can handle that. Let's turn that off. Should be using get any valid position to be able to put it. Oh, what's default mask? It's just filter default. Which is going to include static water, sky, foe, exit, neutral, container, switch, all those. None of those. Can't put item on any of that. There, we have an item on the ground. I think this is better. I want to, if I'm coming into a secret room, like, oh my god, I found a secret room. What the heck? I want to be like, oh yes, the item is there. That's not to say that there might be a further secret. Like, you're like, oh my god, a secret room within a secret room. What? And then that secret could be more hidden or whatever, but this is nice. The first secret, boom, it's visible. Yes, we have secrets in the dungeons now, or in the swordless dungeons. And I want to make sure this doesn't break the way it puts the placement of items, like at the end of this dungeon, for example. That's a good place to check. The item should jump away when you try and grab it. Oh, another genius idea. Oh. If only I had more time before it ruins your game, right? Before it just overwrites your save file. Okay, yeah, I put the sword in the right place. We're good there. And let's check dungeon one, make sure that has its item as well is in the right place. Even with this little slight bit of code that goes, whoop-de-doo, put you in the right place, yay! Alright, cool, we got a check-in. Another check-in. What's that doing there? You mean the item that runs away? All right. Oh, you know what? This is. Oh, you meant the sword? Oh, have you not played that far? In the latest versions? I don't want to ruin anything. Spoiler alert, today's stream is spoiling. Pretty much all the streams from now until the end of the game are going to be spoiler alerts. Oh, you haven't? Wow. Okay, I'm not telling you. Oh yeah, I want to put something in the changelog about this. Changelog, we got to mention some stuff here. Chip killed Dumbledore. That's all I'm going to say about that. All right, man, I'm running out of steam here. I think this is pretty much gonna be it for today's stream. I'll run it one more time though and show you guys what's all the new stuff. What's all the new stuff? Spoiler alert, I'm gonna show something cool. We now have secret pathways. That's something new. Sometimes if you know where the secret is, you can just walk along. Oh, secret path! there's some new dialogue here in the Swordless Dungeon. There's one more cool scene I'm gonna add. It's gonna be sweet. Right here in the beginning of the dungeon. It's gonna show how he steals your sword. And then here's the new sequence where you get the meditation skill. Shadow is not right. The doors slide open. Yeah, you've been there. Okay, right. Yeah, you've been there. All right. Yeah, so I guess tomorrow's stream. I think I'm going to do a stream tomorrow, probably. Yep. By the way, if anybody did not know, Songbringer is on an accidentally deep discounted sale on Humble Bundle this weekend. So if you wanted to get the game, today is the cheapest pretty much day you're ever going to be able to get Songbringer. But I think it's going to be only today and maybe some of tomorrow, I'm not sure. But yeah, it's on Humble Bundle. So thanks for watching, you guys, and have a great Saturday. Enjoy yourselves, and I'll probably see you tomorrow, if not the next day. So cheers, everybody.